Hi, I'm Denby Dung of the Pet Hui. Here's what's coming up in the next half hour.
We'll witness how one person's faith saved a horse from euthanasia, who then in return helped save her. Then, Pet Detective Alpha Dog needs your help to get Dash back home. Plus,
all my life, I've been blessed with the last name Dung. And finally, I met someone who knows the value of poo. Find out more about it on this show. The Pet Hui starts now. Hi, I'm Denby Dung. Welcome to the Pet Hui. I'm here with Allie, and she is known as the Poo Princess. Allie, how did you get that name?
Well, I have a business called Got Poo, pet waste removal and pet services.
Well, my last name is Dung, so I grew up with a lot of dung jokes or poo jokes.
Right.
Like, for example, they asked me, is Donkey Dung your uncle? Or am I related to the dung beetle?
Yeah, I get a lot of poo questions, too.
Like what else?
I hope you're making a poop load of money. You're in a really crappy, you have a really crappy job.
Well, if you want to hear more poop jokes, and who doesn't, stay tuned for more Pet Hui. Now watch this.
In 2014, I lost the love of my life. Then in 2015, God brought one back. You know, her name is Angel for a reason, because she is my angel. This is Angel. We met in October the 1st, she stepped off the plane. She's a tricolored paint. She's a mare. We believe she was a bred mare, which means she was a brood mare. She was used for babies. She's kind of what you would call an alpha mare. They're a little bit pushy. They're opinionated. Ever since I was 5 years old, I wanted a horse, and I had two horses at the age of about 25 or 30, and I ended up having to give them up through some circumstances. I got into the church, and I went on a mission trip to Peru, and while I was there, my boyfriend of 12 years killed himself, and I was pretty devastated. It was a hard time healing. And at that time, I didn't have a horse. And I hadn't been around horses for probably 10 years. I had decided that it wasn't going to be part of my life anymore. But a friend of mine came to the funeral and told me to come back to the barn. And it was a godsend. God had sent her to show me that it was okay for me to be around horses again. So I started hanging out at the barn. And so other people needed people to ride and take care of their horses, so I was starting to do that. And it came to the point about a year later where I decided that it was time for me to get a horse. So I looked online, I looked on Craigslist, I looked at different horse sites. I was looking on the mainland. I was having my friends look, and they were sending me pictures of horses, and I was trying to talk to people about it. I was starting to give up because I didn't think I was gonna find a horse. And then I was looking at my Facebook page, and there she was. She appeared on my Facebook page. I had never known about kill pens and how horses can be rescued from kill pens. I'd never really paid attention to that, but it struck a heartstring. It was like, maybe she needs to be rescued and maybe we can rescue each other. The kill pen is a place where horses go when nobody wants them. They're basically given up, and you know, sometimes they're there for a reason. They're there because they're old and nobody wants them. They're there because they're sick. They're there because they're rank and nobody can handle them. But they get killed and they go for pet food or used for their meat, and they're sold by the pound. And what I understand, there's 20 horses in a pen, and they fight each other, and they have hierarchies. So, you know, the one that might have been used to being the higher guy gets fought with. And that's how come I believe she's an alpha, and she's really self-preservatory because she was in that type of a situation. There's an organization that goes into the kill pens and they videotape and they assess the horses and they try to rehome them. So they put them on this website. They're posted for a week. And if they're not sold within the week, then they go to the slaughter. She was posted, and I decided I wanted to get her, so I started to try to get in touch with them. So I called up the owner, and I pulled out my credit card, and I bought her. I felt like she was an answer to prayer. I was so happy that I was a horse owner again, and I was able to save her, and she wasn't gonna die, and maybe we could help each other. And I knew enough about horses that, you know, normally when you buy a horse, you go and you try it and you ride it and you spend time with it. And I was like, no, this is the horse that God wants for me. So we started the process. Angel was over 5,000 miles away in Louisiana, so I had to make arrangements to get her here. From the day I bought her on August the 28th, it was about 30 days, probably around $7,000, and a village of people to get her here, to have her step off the plane. And they said she was gonna come at about 11 o'clock, and I was sitting there and I'd had everything prepared. I had food ready, I had her stall all cleaned up, and then I saw the trailer pull in, and my heart just jumped. She was my answer to prayer. She was the horse that God sent to me. And when she got out of the trailer, she's a little skinny, but she was quiet. We looked each other in the eye, and it was like, you're home. You're not gonna have to move anymore. You're safe, you're mine, and you're not gonna go anywhere else. This is your home. And we've been together ever since. I made a little picture of her and I walking away that day, and it says, and they lived happily ever after. And she's a gift from God. She challenges me. She's my mirror. She, sometimes we get on each other's nerves, but all in all, she's a good horse. And she has made me a better person because I have learned again how to interact with situations that maybe I might not have encountered if I didn't have a horse again. She was sent to me by God. And we're gonna be together. And she's the reason why I've gotten out of bed a few times when I was grieving, the beginning of the grief. And she's the reason why I've been able to handle a lot of things, because you have to be ready for whatever happens when you have a horse.
Is your yard a minefield? Are the flies driving you crazy?
Hi, I'm Allie the Poo Princess, and I'm cleaning the world of poop one yard at a time.
To have Allie clean your yard, contact her at gotpoo.biz or 497-9273.
What's in your backyard?
Honey, I'm going shopping. Back in 2 hours.
A car dealership right inside a Windward Mall?
It's not just any dealership. It's the Aloha Kia Learning Center.
You can test drive, trade in, get finance, and even buy or lease the 2016 Kia Optima for $98 a month.
That's so low.
Ruff. The new 2017 Kia Sportage SUV for $199 a month.
No way.
Or the new Kia Sedona van for just $225 a month.
Yeah.
I can't wait to show you what I got.
Me too. Come on.
Aloha Kia. See you at Kia.
The Oahu SPCA gives stray, abandoned, and abused animals food, shelter, medical care, and love. We house 150 animals a day and are committed to a no-kill philosophy. If you're looking for a pet, adopt one from Oahu SPCA. Help us with our life-saving work. Please make a donation at oahuspca.org. Call 754-1519 Oahu SPCA.
Welcome back to our show. Once again, we're here with Allie, the Poo Princess of the business Got Poo. And just so you know, she also has a bed and breakfast, but it's not for people. It's only for dogs. Is that right?
That's right. Only for dogs.
Tell us about it.
We only take a couple of dogs, maybe three at one time, and they live with us in our home and do everything we do and get spoiled. And when they go home, they sulk for a couple of days because they have so much fun with us. And then I send pictures and video along the way so that mom and dad can see how much fun they're their pets are having.
So, Allie, if people want to book their pet, what's the best way to contact you?
Call me on 808-497-9273 or contact me through my webpage, gotpoo.biz.
Thank you. Now let's catch up with Pet Detective Alpha Dog because he needs your help to find this missing pet.
Hey gang, Pet Detective Alpha Dog here. My mission is to return pets to their families. Today we're out in the Mauna Wili Estates area of Kailua. We're looking for 3.5-year-old Dash. Let's go in and get some more information. Hi, Aaron.
Hi, yeah.
Hi. Pet Detective. After talking to Aaron, this is what I found out. Now we're looking for Dash. He's a 3.5-year-old male Yorkshire Terrier. He weighs approximately 8 pounds. And last seen, he was wearing a blue plaid collar with ID tags. Now, he's not microchipped or neutered. He is a very friendly little dog, and there is a reward for his safe return. We believe this is how it happened. It was 3 p.m. November 28th, that was on a Monday, that the owner had left Dash right here in the backyard. Now, 30 minutes later, she came back to find Dash gone and a hole under this fence. Most likely, he ran out to the road and took a left. He was last seen by their mailman right up the road about a block. Now, Dash has been missing for over 3 months, and Erin and her family are devastated.
We really miss Dash. He is a loving family member, slept with my son Jackson every night. He was my best buddy, and he was my companion. I'm at home a lot, and he's always with me. We also would hike together, take long walks together, go to the beach together. Our family really misses him. If you know where he is or know of someone that may have him, would you please call us or contact the show? My phone number is 760-845-9663. Dash is a small Yorkie. He's very loving, very friendly, and is a wonderful pet and family member that we miss very much.
Once again, here are the facts. We're looking for Dash. He's a 3.5-year-old male Yorkshire Terrier. He weighs approximately 8 pounds. And when last seen, he was wearing a blue plaid collar with ID tags. Now, he is not microchipped or neutered. He's very friendly, and there is a reward for his safe return. Now, if you have information, or if you know of anybody that has information on Dash, please call the number on the bottom of your screen. Let's try and get Dash safely home, okay? Once again, gang, this is Pet Detective Alpha Dog saying, leash 'em or lose 'em.
Great news, Pet Hui Posse. Thanks to you and Pet Detective Alpha Dog segment, two missing pets have been returned safely to their owners, Chopin and Lucy. Thank you so much for your support and keep up the great work. Now here's more Pet Hui right after this.
Whatever you're looking for this holiday season, you'll find it at the Pet Alley. Maybe toys and supplies for the pets you already love, or maybe a brand new friend. Locally owned and operated, the Pet Alley is a pet store you can trust. And during the week before Christmas, you'll get 15% off all toys and treats at the Pet Alley.
From our family here at the Pet Alley to yours,
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
The Pet Alley in the Mililani Shopping Center.
If your cat is constantly causing trouble, always on the prowl, and never comes when called, you need Acana Regionals cat food. Biologically appropriate food that contains fresh meat, poultry, fish, and game that's rich in protein, low in carbs, and entirely grain-free for a balanced diet. How will your cat act? Well, they'll still cause trouble and they'll never come when called, but you can be sure they're healthy and enjoying the best food available. Acana Regionals, exceptional food for your cat.
Our outdoor lifestyle can really be a disaster to car interiors. That's why Weto Coley has custom seat covers for any make or model, even brand new models off the showroom floor. But whether it's a new car or your favorite beach cruiser, a custom seat cover from Weto Coley is the ticket. You'll find the perfect seat cover in the style you love. You'll also find some nifty accessories. Stop by today and see the incredible selection at 1727 Dillingham Boulevard, 531-9778. Weto Coley.
Welcome back to Hawaii's only TV show about animals, The Pet Hui. We're here with Allie from Got Poo, the Poo Princess. But the more I learn about you, Allie, the more I realize you're about the total wellness of the dog. And I hear you have a canine boot camp.
I have a canine weight loss boot camp.
Tell us all about it.
it's 5 intensive days of exercise for the dog. So we start beforehand with the owners and start working with food and diet and determine with the vet, you know, the condition of the animal and how much weight is necessary to lose. And then we start with 5 days at a time and try and re-educate the owners at the same time. So we do a lot of high resistance, low impact exercises with the animal, and the more overweight, the more water sports we do to help them work that weight off. And then hopefully we just keep on re-educating every month for 5 days until we get to the goal weight with the owner. And hopefully by then we've trained the owner so they don't keep feeding the dog the same stuff that got the dog fat in the first place.
And we're going to hear more about that part after this, but that's amazing. So to find out more about Ali and her boot camp, you can contact her on her website or at the number on your screen. Now here's more Pet Hui.
I'm Norman, and this is my dog, Hokulani. She's an 8-year-old Pomeranian from Hilo. Hokulani, everyone knows, is the known as a sunglasses dog, and a dog that wears costumes and clothes all the time. She does costume contests for Halloween and various company functions that my wife has at the bank, and we do the pet walk and other things. As a sunglasses dog, what we do is she wears different pairs of sunglasses, and she's very comfortable with them. They're actually UV sunglasses for dogs. They're also good for when they're driving in the car. She sticks her head out the window, and debris and other flying objects doesn't get into her eyes. They're the number one cause of eye injuries in dogs, you know, dogs sticking their head out of windows or out of the back of the pickup truck. She wears hats, Lays, Moomoos. She wears Santa Claus hats with beards on them. In response to her popularity, we kind of made her a Facebook page. We started it at the end of November. It's Hokulani. She has about 250 or so friends. We're just starting out. Hoku has 3 cousins, and one of his cousins is named MAX. He's a wire terrier. And when Hoku was small, they used to come over and chase her all around our backyard. And to this day, Hoku has a very good memory of that dog, MAX, and when you say his name, she remembers. Where's Max? Where's Max? Where's Max? Max. Yeah. What dog don't we like? Yeah, we don't like our cousin Max. He chases us all around the place. People ask me where I get her groomed. You know, actually, we do it ourselves, and we use a Flowbee. We normally trim her hair about once a month. You put some spacers on it, turn it on, and you just tap it on her like this. We love Hoku. We take Hoku out wherever we can, and we dress her up. I think people get a kick out of it. I particularly like seeing the joy in people's faces, the smiles. It makes people laugh. We always say if she can make someone laugh or smile, it's a good thing.
Two of the world's top paddlers from Hawaii have decided to take care of a long-time dispute with a friendly race.
Ah, next time. Oh, nice truck liner.
What do you got?
Bro, next time, lava line.
Anybody tell me where this lava lining comes from?
Lava line, 1036 Queen Street, 227-7700. Next time, lavaline.com.
They say the older you get, the wiser. I say the newer you look, the smarter. The Mini has grown up. Introducing the newest Mini, the hardtop four-door. Double the doors and classy, sophisticated, intelligent, and very cool. Or check out the Countryman, Mini's other four-door. Plus the true original, the Mini hardtop two-door. All of this, plus Mini's boot-to-bonnet no-cost 3-year, 36,000-mile maintenance. Mini of Hawaii, all grown up. Welcome back to the Pet Hui. I'm Denby Dung, and this is Ali, the poo princess. And this entire episode is all about poop. But poop jokes aside, Ali, tell us the importance of what you do.
Well, the importance of picking up your dog poop is really important for the environment. So we go around the entire island and we scoop the yards where people are not having the time to do it for themselves. Dog poo is full of bacteria, parasites, and it seeps into our water tables. So we want to scoop it up, and I want to come and scoop it up for you.
Well, now that you've scared the crap out of everyone, tell everyone at home how they can contact you.
You can call me on 808-497-9273, or you can email me, allie@gotpoo.biz, or you can hit my website, gotpoo.biz, and contact us through the contact page.
Now here's more pet hooey.
Hey gang, Pet Detective Alpha Dog here. My mission is to return pets to their families. We're in the Momilani area of Pearl City today, and we're looking for 5-year-old King. Let's go get some more information. Pet Detective Alpha Dog here, Leona, Richard. I want to get some information on King. After speaking with Leona and Richard, this is what I found out. We're looking for King. He's a 5-year-old black and white Lhasa Apso, weighed approximately 13 pounds. Now, he is microchipped, he's neutered, and he's very shy and skittish. He was lost in the Pearl City area, the Momilani area of Pearl City. It was Friday, October 23rd, when the owners came home at 7:30 in the evening and found the leash on the middle of the street, minus King. According to one neighbor, King was in the middle of the street with the leash and the collar still attached. This is how the owners found the leash tangled up in this fence. So we believe that King had jumped over the fence and ran out in the middle of the road. At some point, King got off his leash, ran down the street, and he hasn't been seen since. The Uisados really miss him.
We really miss our dog, King. He's been missing since October 23rd. You know, he's part of our family, and the first few days, I couldn't. I miss him so much.
Yeah, we have a reward for our dog. And
oh, the phone number is 291-7124. 291-7124.
If you decide to keep a pet as your own and it does not belong to you, you do risk prosecution. And remember, leash 'em or lose 'em.
Socialization, or just a nail trim. Tales of Hawaii is here for you. Give us a call at 676-9663.
Your dog is our best friend at Tales of Hawaii.
The VCA Kaneohe Animal Hospital is Oahu's most comprehensive pet clinic for small animals and can provide your dog or cat with everything from annual checkups to specialty care and emergency care. Have a furry feline friend? Check out VCA's Catitude program, which includes a free first exam, a free transport kit, and helpful tips on getting your cat to the clinic. Visit the VCA Kaneohe Animal Hospital on Kamehameha Highway, just a block south of the Likelike, or get to know them online.
Living in Hawaii, you need the best, and WeatherTech floor mats from Wetokoli are the perfect choice. When those unfortunate accidents happen and your plate lunch goes to the floor, WeatherTech mats will be there to protect, and they're easy to clean. Deep channels trap water, dirt, mud, and sand, and they're available for hundreds of makes and models, so no matter what you drive, you'll find the perfect fit. WeatherTech floor mats. Find them at Wetokoli on Dillingham, just Eva of Kalihi Street.
Welcome back to our show, here once again with Allie the Poo Princess, who is just telling us about living healthy with your pet. Allie, whether your dog is overweight or just wants to maintain a healthy lifestyle, what do you recommend?
Well, always a good healthy walk every single day, but also food is really important. Reading the labels and looking for foods that are higher in protein and lower in carbohydrates is very important. Healthy treats are important.
So I hear you have healthy treats?
I do have healthy treats, yes. We make homemade treats. It's all natural, organic products. We even taste test our own products.
Wow. So tell us some examples of healthy treats that you have.
Beef jerky. We do baked salmon skins. We do salmon jerky, chicken, chicken livers, beef livers, pretty much anything that you can think of. We do dehydrated pumpkin for upset tummies.
And I hear you don't even make it until we order it, so it's always fresh.
Always fresh, and if you live locally, I'll even bring it to you.
Okay, Ali, we don't even have enough time to cover all the things that you know and all the wonderful information that you have to offer, so where can people get more information?
Give me a call on 808-497-9273 or go directly to madewithalohatreats.com.
Great, thank you so much, Ali. Now here's more Pet Hui.
Today, it's all about the Maine Coon.
The Maine Coon is a breed that has clawed its way from near extinction to becoming one of the most popular breeds in the country. Cat fanciers say that the Maine Coon's popularity is due to its large size, intelligence, luxuriant coat, gentle and sweet disposition, playfulness, and devotion to its human family. They're friendly to everyone, including children, and are slow to mature, keeping their kittenish behavior for years. The breed is believed to have been on the American continent since the colonial days, perhaps longer. How they got here is anyone's guess. One story is that they were a hybrid between a raccoon and a domestic cat, but that's biologically impossible. Another theory, probably with more credibility, is that they were brought to the U.S. in the 1700s by a sea captain named Coon, who released them in the Northeast, where they established themselves in the severe climate and were used to rid barns and other structures of rats and mice. They are gentle, sweet, and totally affectionate, and make an ideal pet. Everything about the Maine Coon suggests that they were bred to adapt to a harsh climate, including the huge tail, the glossy, heavy, and resistant coat that would protect them against the wet and snow. Males commonly reach 15 to 20 pounds, and females about 10 to 15 pounds. They don't develop quickly and seldom reach their full size until they are 3 to 5 years old. And now you know all about the Maine Coon.
Zane Style House, styling the life you live. Affordable pieces that transition easily through every occasion in your life. From running to pick up the kids, to everyday stylish casual, to that perfect date night, Zane Style House has the perfect outfit for you. Cute, comfy, and fashionable. Zane Style House, styling the life you live. Find us on Facebook and Instagram.